Hello, my broodlings. This is the RPG Check with the Broodling Bulletins update for May 2015. A few things, of course. I want you to help me choose my new intro. I'm getting a new headset and a bunch of other things. First of all, the headset is going to be a Sennheiser PC363D. The reason I'm getting this is the Turtle Beach X11 that I was using, I'm still using, and one ear is hanging off my head, it broke. One of the little swivel pieces that attached to the ear cup just broke off one day, so I've only had it for about a year and a half, and I've since looked up some reviews on it, and a couple other people have said that, yeah, but these do break rather easily. So decided to go with another model, and I'm stepping up my game to a Sennheiser, which is more of a mid-range type of headset. It's originally $300, but they've come down. I could find them at some places for about $120 or so, give or take. So I've looked at and listened to a lot of mic tests on the good old YouTube there, and found that the Turtle Beaches in general had a hum or this faint whine that you can hear behind it, like this one. Has a whine. If you turn it really high up, you might be able to hear it in the background. The razors gave like this hollow sound to the voice. I didn't really like it that much. So the Sennheiser is a great mic, and it's noise canceling. There's a couple episodes of Lunar where I'm not sure if they're up yet, but you can hear birds in the distance during quiet parts. Those birds are outside, and it was like 3 in the morning. So the noise-canceling mic would be great, and it is very durable. Lasts for a long time, so I won't have to worry about, forking over another $100-something, in a year or two. Hopefully. And it is a surround sound headset. You're not going to be able to hear that on my videos, of course. That's not too big of a factor for me. But with some games, like modern games, you could hear enemies like behind you or to the side of you, and you could tell where they're coming from. So this seems pretty neat. And what I was really looking for was the quality of the mic. And I looked far and wide and could not find a mic better than this one until I went to Sennheiser. So there are some other really good models that will, make your wallet scream, and those mics are probably good too, but they are a little bit more expensive than the model I'm looking at. This one came out back in 2012 or something like that, so I can get it at a vast discount. So in the next update, you might hear me with a new mic. I might sound even better than this. Who knows? Okay, next on the agenda, I have a new intro. This guy is amazing. He writes mods, which are, it's tracked music used, made with a computer. So I found him on modarchive.com. A bunch of his songs are up there, and really great. His name's Hayao Chan. And I'm going to have, at the beginning, for those familiar with my channel, at the beginning of the first episode of every Let's Play, I have an intro that runs for about 20-something seconds. So this is going to be replaced with this song, and it's going to have, of course, new footage. That intro was recorded back in, 2013 or something, maybe? So there were a lot of old games in there, so we're going to have, going to mix it up. Again, it's going to be a 20-something second intro. But what I'm going to have is the beginning of every video. I'm going to have a really short intro, just saying RPG Check, maybe some effect or something like that. I don't know what I'm going to come up with. I'm not an animator, so I'm not really good at that stuff. So I'm going to have to find some kind of effect or something, some way to make it look kind of cool. But anyway, the first intro goes like this. It's about 10 seconds. Now that's the intro that I personally like a lot more, but it does run for 10 seconds, and that might irritate people coming, you know, in the beginning of every video. Some people might be a little annoyed by it. So yeah, that's the beginning of the song by Hayo Chan. I'll put a link to his channel. And the end, the explosion at the end, is the Celestial Host spell from Planescape Torment. The very end, when the dragon, you know, spews forth, you know, whatever, laser or, you know, fire or something like that. Very awesome spell. It's the only game I've played which I can remember having these awesome animations just for a spell, you know? Some of them would go on for a minute. Anyway, I'm getting derailed again with Planescape Torment. So that's the first one, and I have an alternate one that is a lot shorter. However, it doesn't have the beat and everything. Well, just listen for yourself. So it's less than half. We're talking 4 seconds versus 10. So if you guys think that would be too long, you know, the 10-second one is just too long to put in the beginning of every video, you know, at the front of every video, gameplay video. And then, you know, of course, after that, it would go right to the gameplay. It would fade in from there. And, of course, I'm going to have a little, you know, video montage or something like that, like I said. So, one or the other. I prefer the first, but it's a little longish. Maybe you guys don't think it's a problem. Maybe it's worth it. You know, I like the beat. I like the explosion at the end. It's freaking awesome. You know, it's an RPG spell. So it kind of shows you, you know, where we've come from. You know, starts off sounding like, you know, the first NES Nintendo and to Planescape Torment. So it's the evolution, you know, and of course we've evolved way past there, but I feel like that's a good representation. So yeah, what do you think? Longer intro or shorter one? So here's the long one again. And then this one, the shorter one, that doesn't have quite nearly the impact as the first, but it does have a mysterious sound to it. So that's it. What do you think? Longer, shorter? Leave your comments below. Thanks. Appreciate it. In other news, Game of Thrones just came out with a new episode a couple days ago. I finished playing it. It is now uploading as we speak daily. So I really enjoyed the heck out of this one, and, you know, it was a little less depressing than last episode. There's a little, you know, some at least minor triumphs throughout, I feel. So that's that, and then in our second slot, after Game of Thrones is done, I'm going to be playing this game called The Vanishing of Ethan Carter. It's supposedly, from what I can tell, it's an action adventure kind of game, but it's a horror game. Or I don't think it's full-on horror. I might be surprised by that. It might be a little scarier than I'm thinking. So I usually don't play those kind of games because I get really scared. So, you know, there might be some headphone, you know, kind of ouchies, you know, for people listening on headphones. I don't know. I'm going to be playing it blind, of course. So that's that. And after that's a pretty shortish game from what I heard, so after that will be Walking Dead from Telltale Games, Season 1 and 2. That's for the second slot. Pillars of Eternity is going to be going to 2 o'clock. I used to have the first slot come in around 2 o'clock and then the second slot around 7. And I don't know, somehow they got switched. So Pillars of Eternity is going to be going to 2 o'clock and it's going to be daily. What about Lunar, you ask? Lunar is going to alternate with the second slot until it's done. We have about a dozen, maybe so, videos left. You know, of course, every other day, that's going to go on for almost a month. So it's going to alternate with the second slot, which will be Ethan Carter and The Walking Dead. Once Game of Thrones is done, all this stuff is going to switch around. So that's that. there is a Kickstarter coming up for Bard's Tale 4. It's going to be coming up on June 2nd on Kickstarter itself, so keep in tune for that. It's coming out from In Exile Entertainment. It's the 30th anniversary of the original game's release. They have the right to use all the stuff from the original trilogy, so anything that you may be familiar with, locations such as that, they're able to put in the game. It's coming out for PC and possibly other platforms as well, so I might be voting on that one. I have to see a little footage. I have to see a little bit more of what it's exactly about. I don't know if it's going to be a retro kind of thing in the style of the older games, or if it's going to be completely redone 3D. I'm guessing it will with the Unreal 4 engine. It's going to be completely 3D and everything. So with that kind of thing, yeah, I might just be voting on that one. So I want to thank you guys for watching. Yeah, see you in the Let's Plays.